With many parents in the workforce, children are being left home alone more often and at younger ages. But regardless of whether it's a routine or an unforeseen circumstance that leaves them by themselves, it's important these children have a safe home alone experience. And Mindy Johnston develops and teaches a safe home alone readiness program to boys, girls, and parents. Welcome back, Mindy. It's always great to have you.
Thank you. It's great to be back.
All right. So what factors should you consider before you decide you want to leave your child home alone?
It's so important to consider their maturity level, their self-confidence, decision-making skills, and certainly their level of responsibility.
Now, is there a legal age?
Not in Connecticut. Most states do not have legal ages. Some have recommended ages, and some have a minimum age of 8 years old, such as Maryland and North Carolina.
All right, so are you seeing more and more kids being left home alone?
Yeah, there are. Because more parents are going back to work, more kids are being left home alone, whether it's for a few minutes or a few hours.
All right, so what are some of the tips that parents need to know to keep their kids safe?
Okay, the most important thing is communication with your child. Talk about different possibilities just so they're prepared if they're ever in such a situation to know how to deal with it.
So actually talk about this, create a situation for them, sort of what are you going to do if somebody knocks at the door?
Exactly.
Really go through the details, right?
That's a big one, because most often burglars will knock on a door before breaking in. They want the path of least resistance. They want to get in, get out. They want the jewelry, the electronics. They don't want witnesses. So it is important to tell your child that if someone comes to the door, never open it, but to talk through the locked door, make yourself visible. If they're more comfortable having a phone in hand, that's fine too.
And if that person pursues beyond the door, should they just get out of the house?
Absolutely. They should call 911 first. Get that call. Don't call their parents. That's what happens. Sometimes children will call their parents because they're most comfortable, but their parents aren't going to be able to do anything if they're 30 miles away at work. Call 911.
Okay, let's go through some of the tips. You say keep all the doors and windows locked, but also they need to know how to unlock them.
They do need to know how to unlock them. And part of my course, I talk about different scenarios, such as we've just mentioned, but I tell true stories. And last summer, two brothers, ages 11 and 13, were home alone on a hot summer day. Parents were at work, but their doors were unlocked. They noticed a man coming up the driveway, and so they had been told by their mother to run upstairs if anyone ever came to the house. And so they did, without locking the doors and without bringing a
portable
phone. So
they should have locked the doors and taken the phone and called 911?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, also you say know the locations of all your exits and the phones.
It's important, because when people are stressed or in some type of situation where there's a lot of anxiety, they're not thinking clearly. I tell the students in my course, if you have a portable phone, keep it with you at all times. You don't want to start going through the house looking for a phone in another room.
And you said, you already said this, always talk through a locked door, never really pretend that no one is home. And you say, do not open the door for anyone unless you have your parents' permission to let them in.
Right. The majority of sexual assaults are committed by people that children know. So you need to check with your parents that it's okay, that if someone's at the door, to let them in. Parents may not want anyone in while they're not home.
All right, and if you're feeling that immediate danger, call 911.
And it's important to know where you live, your nearest cross street, how many houses are you from it, on the right or left. Is your number visible on the mailbox or the house? These are all things that will help emergency personnel get to you much quicker.
And really quickly, have a secret family password.
Absolutely. I hear sometimes parents say they would never send anyone their child does not know to pick them up. Never say never.
That's right.
Accidents and emergencies are not planned.
Now, if you miss any of these tips, all you have to do is find them at WTNH.com. Just click on Connecticut Style. Mindy, thank you again for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
You're welcome. Bye.